Britain in the United Kingdom. United Kingdom is made up of England, Scotland, Wales. England, Scotland and Wales. The Scottish want to break away from the British. The Welsh want to be able to speak their own language. What do you think would happen if some foreign government decided to arm the Welsh or arm the Scottish? And then just an incident happens whereby an English policeman kills the Scots and the Scottish people come out in protest. Some of them have guns. That's how the IRA started. That's why we had a campaign of terror where the Irish were bombing Britain for 30 years. Now when, perhaps this is just poetic justice for Libya. Because when the Irish, the IRA, were fighting against the British, it is well known that Gaddafi supported them with arms, with Semtex. But that's not too bad, because the main supporters of the IRA were the Americans. The Americans were the main financiers and backers of the Irish campaign against the British. My friends, let's be honest, he raised a point there. And his point of view is very important. It's wrong, but it's important because the majority of the public think like that. Why do they think like that? Because they are ill-informed. Propaganda by the media. How many times have you seen on the BBC a representative of the Libyan government being given a time to talk to the people and explain what's going on? They don't give them any airtime. Sir! I monitor the media. I'm a journalist. Sir! My television is on BBC News 24 hours. And I monitor the amount of anti-war points of views that are being presented. Or the government. When the rebels claim Gaddafi's killed civilians here, why don't they give the Libyan government the opportunity to rebut them? But they don't want the Libyan government to have any oxygen amongst the public. However, the Israelis shoot down Palestinians. Recently, the Palestinians gathered on the Syrian border, on the Lebanese border, on the Gazan border. In one day, the Israelis shut down 14. Did the Western media allow the protesters to have a point of view? No! They gave us every Israeli spokesperson under the sun. Mark Regev. They gave us every Israeli spokesperson. So the Israelis are given the airtime, the propaganda time, to win you over, the public. But the Palestinian protesters are never given any airtime. This is the subtlety of propaganda. It's propaganda! But we don't question it. When we see someone on television, that person is in our homes. Now the average person is apolitical. Joe Public isn't really concerned about politics. They're concerned about Paris Hilton. They're concerned about Victoria Beckham. They're concerned about where they're going clubbing or where they're going to go to for a drink on a Friday and a Saturday night. So when this information comes to them from the respected BBC or other news associations, the public buy the news without questioning the legitimacy of the content. This is the problem we are in. Protest has been stifled, and that's why I was so proud when the students came out on the streets and began to march and demand their rights. Yes, it is stifled, but it is that public protest that we need right now. In Africa, whilst members of the West were bombing Libya, the French were bombing the Ivory Coast, backed up by the United Nations. The United Nations has now become an arm of NATO, an arm of Western imperialism. The United Nations is nothing but a rubber stamp for Western policy. And how do they do it? Because the United Nations represents the world. Let me tell you. Recently you've heard David Cameron say, we're going to increase our aid budget. Why so? How are you, my brother? Here we have a legend. A legend of Speaker's Corner. A legend of Speaker's Corner. Why so? A man who also inspired me to speak. A man who also influenced my style. So I'm glad to see you, Roy. Yes, my brother. Legend. Main man, why you just stopped me? You've just thrown me. Man, it's good to see you, Roy. Where was I? How do you do it? Where was I?
We were talking about United Nations.
Ah, it's how do they do it with the United Nations? How does the United Nations, how is the United Nations become a rubber stamp? Simple. You've heard David Cameron talk about we have to increase our overseas aid budget. Why would all these nations who are in a time of global economic crisis be talking about increasing their aid budget? Why is America, in the crisis it's in, talking about increasing its aid budget? Why is Britain talking about increasing its aid budget? Simple, because they ply all of these so-called developing countries with aid. They are dependent upon that aid. And any time they go against the grain of Western opinion, they are threatened that they will lose their aid. Don't you remember what happened in the Libya, in Iraq? Resolution 1441? The French were opposed to it. Nations were opposed to it. The Americans knew they would not pass the resolution, so they went behind the scenes. As Piers Morgan from the Daily Mirror said, he aptly summed it up. He said it was a coalition of the bullied, the bribed, and the terrified. They bribed Turkey. They bribed Turkey by claiming they're going to wipe debt. Hold on, sir. We Africans, Guinea sat as part of the 15-member Security Council. And look at how we Africans, we always let ourselves down. We go cheap. Turkey got a deal of $2 billion to vote with the Americans. Guinea, they gave Guinea $10 million. And we the Africans are like, look, we made something for nothing. One for you, one for me. One for you, one for me. Guinea got $10 fucking million. This is the ridiculousness of it. Nations are bribed. And then we have this word, this euphemism, the international community. They don't say the United Nations anymore. They say the international community demands this. The international community wants that. When they say the international community, who do you think they're referring to? My brothers in Nigeria, my sisters in Pakistan, my brothers in Bahrain, in Afghanistan, Pakistan. No. When they use the euphemism, the international community, they mean America, Britain, France, Spain, Italy, Germany, America, Canada, New Zealand, Australia. They mean all the white Western nations. That's what they mean when they say the international community.
Yes, sir. The
Italians, look at Berlusconi. He's a damn mafia. The mafiosi.
Okay. What he said to me was, he's quoting Piers Morgan.
Piers Morgan.
Yeah. Interesting point. Piers Morgan. Piers Morgan, the man who's on the Mirror.
That's right. He was the editor of the Mirror.
A man whose record of lying about pushing stories in, he knows to be untrue.
He says a man's record, a man whose record for pushing stories in. What you are referring to is a simple story whereby there was an alleged case of abuse of Iraqis by British soldiers. And he published the photographs where it was later claimed they were staged photographs. Now, is that what you're holding against Piers Morgan?
I'm saying, if you look at his record, he's a man, okay, I wasn't even thinking about pictures. He's a man who's lied on celebrities. He's lied on
celebrities. He's lied on celebrities. Sir! Yeah. I'm not defending Piers Morgan. Right, I'm quoting Piers Morgan. Piers Morgan said, this was a coalition of the bullied, the bribed, and the terrified. And because it is accurate, I choose to use it. But you say, dismiss it. Who should I quote? The Dalai Lama? My friend, we had at the same time, Kofi Annan.
Kofi Annan.
Kofi Annan is discredited. Now look at Kofi Annan. What discredits Kofi Annan is not his words, it's his action. Kofi Annan was the Secretary General of the United Nations, a puppet of the West. Now hold on, sir. That chicken bone witch doctor. Let me tell you what it is.
I know that is.
The Americans invade Iraq. Kofi Annan says nothing.
For a year.
It takes one whole year before Kofi Annan makes a public statement about the invasion of Iraq. And then Kofi Annan comes on stage and he says, some nations are unhappy with the invasion, the legality of the war. The war was illegal. He said it was an illegal invasion. That was the words of Kofi Annan. And then the Western powers, through the Western media and all of their power entities, They then drag up a story about Kofi Annan's son, Benedict Fitting from the oil